But today, we're gonna go through how a mini lab works. And I'm gonna show you how this roll of film ends up as quality scans of photos in my email inbox. Okay, so I have made it to Tampere once again, and it's super warm here. It's very warm in the whole of Finland right now. Camerarescue is like a few blocks that way. Also, I decided to just give up on these parts and do the filming on my phone instead of my camera, because my camera is way too shaky for this, so just bear with the audio, okay? And there's the building. Oh, and that's a C330. That's almost just like mine. But it's even bigger. It's actually seriously a bit heavier than mine. A Kiev 60, which is the best worst medium format camera you can get. I mean, it's much cheaper than the Pentax 6.7, but it shoots 6.6 and it's extremely unreliable. Okay, so I have two rolls of film. I have one roll of Portra 400, which was shot in a Canon FT that my friend has. And then I got a roll of Kodak Ektachrome, which I shot in my very, very basic M42 screw mount SLR. Wanted to try out Ektachrome because I earlier shot some Velvia and I really loved it, but I wanted something that had a bit more wiggle room compared to Velvia 50, so Ektachrome it is. But today we're gonna go through how a mini lab works. We're gonna soon go downstairs to the lab and I'll show you the process of how this roll of film ends up as pictures in my email. So let's go check that out. Okay, so we have arrived in the lab and here is the mini lab that's used here. So it's a Fuji mini lab and it's actually quite small. It's not one of the bigger ones. We're gonna develop my roll now. So let's see how the process goes. We have arrived here in my backyard. I'm just gonna do this with a voiceover because at the lab we decided that it's easier to just do the job there and then voiceover it later. The first thing that happens when the film comes into the lab is that it is assigned this number that's on a sticker. And you've probably seen these if you use a lab sometimes. And there are two stickers, one that goes onto the envelope your film is in and the other goes to the leader of your film. First thing to do is retrieve the film leader from the canister. They just use a machine where you put the film roll in, then do some magic and boom, out comes the film leader. The lab technician told me that this machine works really well with 36 exposure rolls, but with some 24 exposure rolls, sometimes with those rolls, you need to use the manual film retrieval tools. Then the film leader gets attached to this plastic sheet thingy that will actually travel through the machine and pull the film with it. Then you take your roll and put it in this compartment here, and then you just beep, press a button and the machine pulls your whole roll of film inside the machine. And after that, the machine starts the whole development process. First development, then bleach, then fix, and finally stabilizer. And the one thing that this machine does very well, and it's part of why mini labs are still super important, is that it is fast. It takes only like 15 minutes for a whole roll to get developed. And the part about this machine is that when it gets ready, it spits out your film and it has been dried. The machine dries it for you, so it just spits out a completely dry roll of developed film. The lab at Camera Store also does E6 slide development and black and white film development, but those are done completely manually with the Jobo. One thing I learned is that when choosing a lab, it's not always the best idea to choose a lab that's not used that often, because you would think that, oh, if this lab doesn't have that many clients, they can put more care into my film. But sometimes that actually might not be a great idea. And that's because these machines require some amount of rolls going through them on a pretty regular basis for them to keep in shape. The machines can actually degrade if you don't use them regularly enough. So if you want very reliable results, you should use a lab that is used by other people also. One thing one of the viewers actually asked in the Camerarescue Instagram is that what kind of brand of mini lab do you use and is it better than this other brand and that, for example.
And I asked the lab tech and I also asked Juho, and they gave me a really good answer. And it's that nowadays, in this day and age, it really doesn't matter anymore what kind of mini lab you use. Just every lab has their one mini lab that they are trying to keep alive for as long as possible. And that's just because support for these machines is dwindling really fast. And sometimes if something breaks, you kind of have to pray that it's a part that you can actually replace. And some of the plastic parts, for example, in the machine are really prone to breaking nowadays after whole lot of years in use. Once the machine spits it out, you can examine it in the light table next to the machine, and it's good to check the edge markings that to see that the film has actually developed correctly. But after this, the film is brought upstairs for scanning. The scanner used at the camera store lab is the Noritsu HS1800A. Here you have the choice of basic resolution and premium resolution. I got my roll scanned in both the basic resolution and the premium resolution, and I would say that you don't lose any detail if you scan at only the basic resolution. It's mostly just about getting a bigger file size if you want to do bigger prints, for example. I would say for 95% of work that you want to do with your film scans, the basic scan will do just fine. The software used for controlling the scanner is actually really basic. It's basically just a drop-down menu for choosing the resolution and then just a button that says scan. But the biggest thing about the scanner that actually surprised me the most is that it's so fast. Especially if you're used to home scanning with an Epson flatbed, this will just blow your mind. The basic resolution scan comes off from the machine in about 2 minutes. Under 2 minutes, actually. So it scans the whole roll of film in under 2 minutes, which is crazy. And for the premium scans, the machine takes about 7 minutes, which still is really fast compared to an Epson, for example. And here we come to the thing that in labs is much more important than at home. And it's the number one thing for labs, and that is speed. Because for a lab, the most important thing is the question of how many rolls they can process in one day. But when the lab works correctly, it's really fast and it's really well organized, and actually really cool how fast it works.
I hope you enjoyed this dive to how a mini lab here at Cameratori actually works. This was suggested by one of the community members who watches these videos. So if you have anything like this that you would want to know or want to see, comment it down below and I will surely read it. And if you like these kinds of videos, please make sure to put a thumbs up on it down below and comment and subscribe to this channel also. And go follow me on Instagram so you'll see more pictures and behind the scenes stuff when it comes out. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.